Hvis man skal se en rigtig naturby og noget rigtig flot natur med både bjerge og sol og høj blå himmel og klar luft, så er Denver en rigtig, rigtig godt tilbud. Denver er en by, som er hastigt på vej, en af de byer i USA, som vokser mest med turisme. Og det er faktisk ret imponerende, fordi man har ikke de der store symboler, som man har i New York med Frihedsgudinden eller Golden Gate eller Pier 39 i San Francisco. Det man har i Denver, det er natur, meget, meget glade mennesker, og så har man et forbløffende antal øl. Man har faktisk over 100 bryggerier i downtown Denver, og man skal ikke gå ret langt før, så er der en bar. Og Denver har også noget andet, som er meget specielt, og det er, at man har liberaliseret muligheden for at købe cannabis, altså marihuana. Man kan simpelthen gå ind på en bar, man kan gå ind på en købmandsforretning, og så kan man købe noget marihuana. Man kan kun købe til personlig brug, man kan kun købe et bestemt antal. Det har man gjort for, at det selvfølgelig ikke skal sælges videre. Og det er meget vigtigt, man må ikke tage det ud af staten. Man skal bruge det, mens man er her. Det har givet et løft på turismen her til Denver, og det har ikke alene givet et løft, det har givet en meget, meget stor PR-mæssigt baggrund for, at der er mange, mange mennesker. En undersøgelse har vist, at 26% de ser positivt på Denver og muligheden for at besøge Denver på grund af den liberaliserede marihuana-lov, mens 14%, kun 14% siger, at de ser negativt på det og ikke vil besøge Denver på grund af marihuana-lovgivningen. As a tourist from Denmark, I can go to New York, Los Angeles, San Francisco, and so on. Why should I go to Denver?
I think because it's the most friendly city in the beginning of the West, which is what everyone's excited to see in America. So it's the gateway to the Rocky Mountain West.
Okay, and what if you should say five things you have to see in Denver, what should that be?
Well, probably number one is Red Rocks, where musicians from around the world want to play on the stage, but it's also a park during the day, so you can enjoy hiking and look at nature. Secondly, I might buy a shirt, a cowboy shirt, a western shirt, at Rock Mount Ranchwear, where the first snap button shirt was invented, right in downtown Denver. And I definitely go to one of our museums, the Denver Art Museum, the Kirkland Museum. They're all in walking distance. It's a very walkable downtown. And then I would definitely taste some craft beer. We are one of the capitals in America for some of that yummy craft beer, and they're all very creative and crazy and wonderful people that are running the breweries.
How many breweries do you have in Denver?
About 100 in Denver alone. And we're also the home of Coors, which makes Blue Moon and all those great beers. And lastly, you must taste the food by the chefs, because there are creative artists in Denver, but there's also creative chefs in Denver.
This year you are the host of the IPW. We have just heard from Washington, they were the host last year and they got about 800,000 more tourists. How many more tourists do you expect because of the IPW?
Well, we know from the research in the past that it's around 700,000 to 800,000 in the 3 years that follow you hosting this wonderful event. So we're very excited to bring more economic impact and more visitors into Denver and Colorado.
As I understand, in 2016 you were breaking the 30 million mark for tourists to Denver, and it was 31.5. How many will it be for 17?
I think it'll be a bit more than that. We're edging up every year, so maybe 32 million, 33 million. I haven't heard I don't have the numbers yet.
Okay, and if you should divide them up, how many are overseas, and especially how many are from Scandinavia and from Denmark?
They're pretty small numbers right now. That's why we're hoping that we really raise them. So I would say it's under a million a year out of all of those numbers are coming from out of the country. And the Scandinavian market, we need much more. We need many more of them to come because it's a small number of our our incoming clients.
I talked to the one of the managers from the airport, and he said that they are negotiating with Copenhagen, and they hope within 3 years to get a direct flight from Copenhagen to Denver. And do you have any knowledge about that, or do you? Of course, you wish that, but
yes, of course, we work together very closely with the airport. We already have the Iceland Air connections, and of course, United. We're a Star Alliance hub, so lots of options. British Airways, and Edelweiss will be coming from Switzerland, and I think there's lots of options on all of the major carriers because Denver International Airport is the fifth largest in the United States. So we have all of the major U.S. carriers coming to Denver as well.
But how will you be more visible in Denmark or in Scandinavia?
Well, we're definitely doing many of the consumer shows and we're dealing with the trade, the travel companies, and then we host journalists quite often to come to Denver and Colorado. So we're definitely working with all of the people on the ground in Scandinavia, Denmark for sure. It's a very good market for us. They love to come and spend money and explore the West. So Denmark is one of our targets.
I have to be honest, I can't remember I've ever seen an advertising for Denver in my country.
Well, consumer advertising is very expensive, so we often work with the travel trade and try to work with them with their customers who already love America so that it's more concentrated, because obviously daily advertising would be very expensive.
Okay, cannabis tourism, you are one of the few places in the United States where you're allowed to buy cannabis for your own consumption. You're not allowed to bring it out of the states. What has it meant for the tourism in Colorado and in Denver?
Actually, I think people come to Colorado and Denver for many reasons, and they may participate in cannabis when they're here, but the reasons they come are still the great Rocky Mountains, the great people, the national parks, the things to see and do, the sports, professional sports. We have 7 teams in Denver alone. And so we have not seen that this is the reason they come. It may be something that they do while they're here, but the reasons they come are the same reasons that they came many years ago. We've been increasing tourism for the last 10 years, every year.
But hasn't there been a rush for cannabis tourism?
Not that I'm aware.
Not that you're aware. Okay. I understand that you have this very, very fast connection from the airport to the city center. Can you tell me a little bit about that, how old it is and what the price is?
Yes, we have a rail service from Denver International Airport right into the center of the city, and they arrive at Denver Union Station, which is just a beautiful, not like some of the European stations I've seen, but it's beautiful, and it has a hotel and restaurants, and it only takes about 37 minutes. It's been running for about a year and a half, 2 years now, and it costs $9 for a day pass throughout the region of the system. We have many light rail tracks around the city as well.
What time of the year is the best time to visit Denver? What I heard was that you can have all the climate in one day in Denver, but what time is the best?
Well, I think any time's the best, but I personally love September because it has the blue skies that are so beautiful, and sometimes it's cooler at night. It's just a beautiful time of the year, but really any time. We can have golfing weather in January when they're skiing in the mountains. So Denver is a pretty warm and easy to get around state city all through the year.
As I understand, your strategy is that you want to grow as a tourist destination, but you don't want to have the effect from the tourism. You still want to be a nature city and protect nature. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
I think all of us that live here are very aware of the beauty of the outdoors, and we spend a lot of time in our buildings. The convention center itself is a green certified building. We talk a lot about less car traffic and more alternative traffic. We walk a lot in the city. We bike much like, not as well as Copenhagen, I must say, but we are trying to encourage our city to be more like Copenhagen. And I think that we still are not New York. We're not the first place people go. So we're for the adventurous traveler who loves the United States and wants to meet real people, which you will when you come here. Just go to a bar and use your accent and you'll meet someone wonderful within 10 minutes.
Okay, thank you very much and good luck.
Thank you. Thank you for coming to visit.
Denver skal besøges på alle tider af året, siger Jane Burke. som er vice president for tourism i Visit Denver. Hun fortæller, at i september måned, når at himlen er blå, og der er klart vejr, og der er fine farver i naturen, så er det hendes favorittid at besøge Denver. Men hun er selvfølgelig ansat i turistministeriet, eller turistkontoret, så hun siger, at alle dage af året, der kan man besøge Denver. Faktisk er det sådan, at man siger, at vejret er så svingende, så man kan opleve de fire årstider på bare en enkelt dag. Hun fortæller, at man har for første gang i 2016 passeret at have over 30 millioner turister, og hun fortæller, at der vil blive flere for 2017. Hun fortæller også, at hun meget, meget gerne vil have, at der kommer flere turister fra Danmark, og man vil arbejde sammen med turistbranchen og flyselskaber osv. for at prøve at få flere turister. Man er også i gang med at gøre sin huse grønne med Københavns Lufthavn. Faktisk mangler man et flyselskab, fordi man vil gerne have en direkte rute fra København til Denver. Og hun håber, at det kan blive inden for 3 år, det sker. Så fortæller hun, at marihuana har betydet noget PR-mæssigt, men man har ikke nogen opgørelse over, hvor meget det egentlig har betydet for, hvor mange flere turister man har. Men hun repræsenterer en strategi om, at man meget, meget gerne vil have en forøgelse af turismen i Denver, men det må ikke gå ud over byen, det må ikke gå ud over naturen. Man har nogle skrappe regler for, hvad man skal gøre. Blandt andet vil man gerne lave mere offentlig trafik. Og en af de bedste ting, man har gjort, hvad det angår, det er, at man kan køre fra lufthavnen, fortæller hun, på 37 minutter fra lufthavnen til midten af byen i Denver, og det koster den forbløffende sum af $9. Og det er jo rimelig lidt i forhold til, hvis man for eksempel skulle tage en taxa. Og jeg kender ingen andre, i hvert fald ikke ret mange byer i USA, hvor man også har en så hurtig forbindelse, kun 39. Hun er meget, meget glad for danske turister, og hun vil gerne byde mange flere velkommen.